Coffee Table Muse.
Boy, that was that
funny
was.
And
I know, I like but that it. That was kind of written. It was a dialogue between me and my ego when I was trying to get it, and
alter
it's just,
ego.
Yeah, not the great side of the ego. So when I look at it, it's just little stuff. I don't. To me, I didn't write this. It's like it wrote itself on coasters and pieces of paper, and I'll just read where it started. So this was. We're putting this up as a blog, of course, but it's just one of those books you pick it up and it's just relevant at the time. And it starts off the wake. I saw the death of someone close to me, someone I'd known my whole life. Someone who at stages was my best friend, but in the end I realised it was all about them with no consideration for me at all. So here I am at the wake, enjoying every moment. I'm actually quite happy to see this character go, for life has such joy and peace that I wished I'd removed this troublemaker from my life years ago. So yes, I'll have another beer and say farewell to my ego.
Well done.
So it's funny because I even had to put, like, I'm a terrible, my grammar and all that sort of thing, you'd never know that I had a private education, but I,
Your mind goes faster than what you can write. Let's leave it
and out. I leave out whole sentences. I think them in my head, but I can't keep up with the thoughts, and I read them back and I think, is this like, so this is how the book's written. So I put a special note to readers. I need to say right up front, my spelling is terrible, grammar is even worse, but I don't give a shit. If you do, I forgive you. Love and hugs. So there's some, you know, it's all about my relationship with different people. And, you know, there was, you know, I looked at my ego and it's really funny.
It's almost sporadic.
Over a couple of years. I'm just trying to find another bit. There was one particular part and I can tell you how it came about. And it was, you know, each bit I could basically remember where I was sitting at the time that it came out. And this particular one, I was looking after a friend's cat. And I'm in the kitchen and the cat ran into the corner cupboard when I opened it. And I'm like, the cat wouldn't come out with it. So I thought, all right, I'll get you. So I shut the cupboard. And a few minutes goes by and all of a sudden the cat's meow, meow. And all of a sudden, I thought, by the cat, I've just got this idea. And this is what I wrote. Pussy in the cupboard. We can be quick to jump into a situation as the cat that jumps into the cupboard when you open it, looking for a new adventure. Yet once inside the cupboard, soon discovers, especially if you close the cupboard, that this is not the adventure it was looking for. Might this be the case of life? We are quick to jump, possibly followed by a darkness that makes us realise that cupboards don't hold our dreams, but our soul does.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Mm. Well, thank you.
Got a little goosey there. That's, but I like the dark bit too.
Yeah.
You think you're jumping in somewhere that's going to make you safe, but in actual fact it's not.
Yeah, I know.
It scares you even more.
I know. It's got some funny ponderings. And this is one of my ego. This was sort of like, how do you get rid of your ego? You know, I wish someone could just come and take it and get rid of it because it's always there. So I wrote this, ego looking for roommate. I moved recently and it was about time. I'd been living with my ego since puberty. Finally, I'd had enough of its whining, complaining and opinions. So I moved in with my body again, a place that I'd lived as a child. However, when puberty happened, I moved in with my mind and rarely kept contact with my body at all. Now I've cut all ties with my ego and I'm getting to know my body again. So far, I'm amazed at just how much we have in common, which wasn't the case with my ego at all. Anyway, now I have a fully furnished ego for rent. It comes with its attitude and its own opinions. Please do not apply direct, as it doesn't quite know I've gone yet and will talk about me all day long. Come directly to my body and knock on my heart. I'm residing there these days. Yeah.
That's fantastic. I'm not even trying to be nice.
It's one of those books you open every bit. Here's ego.
I want it.
I'm aware of you. All changes from now on will be dealt with my soul. Sorry, ego, but I'm awake to you. So I just, you know. So there's a few books in that series. And I didn't write it. Just the stuff just came.
Yeah.
And whenever I tried to rewrite, like if I think, the grammar isn't right or I haven't said that right, I mean,
it's
swearing and everything. And I went, no, that's the way it had to be. So
I'm sure
I
must have seen a bumper sticker.
They come to me all the time. I honestly, very organised in my place, but I've got pads everywhere with just little quotes in them and that's basically how they were written.
Thank God for all of us that you're organised. Otherwise it would be
a little bit anal sometimes. I like things, you know, certain
way. Well,
you
just get
a lot
done in this lifetime of yours. You've done amazing.
Well, it's amazing how many more hours you have when you don't have a TV.
Actually, Will.i.am said that recently.
Who?
Will.i.am from Black Eyed Peas. They said to him, so how many hours do you get? And he said, oh, probably about 4 hours a night. He said, it's fantastic. I've got an extra 20 hours a day.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone else is thinking about sleeping. But
yeah,
to his mind,
well,
he's like...
When you understand the planet cycles too, full moon, I don't bother going to bed half the time because you're awake, you're
and
in work, you're getting
so,
in.
Yeah.
So I'll dance and... You know, I'm up there at 2 o'clock in the morning. I'm still on the computer doing things or researching,
writing books.
And yeah. So I work with the cycles anyway. People say, "Aren't you tired?" And it's like, no, because you actually don't need as much sleep once you start to get your vibration.
So can I just get you to confirm for me that if I'm trying to be the 9 to 5 person to fit in there, and it just doesn't work because at 7:30 to 9 o'clock at night. My mind comes alive with what it's meant to do.
Yep. We
Should
have, we
I
have
try
different
and
cycles.
Do my 9 to 5 or say, let's do 9 to 5 in a night time?
Next, you've got to find what your cycle is. Everyone's got a cycle. Like sometimes I go through stages where I sit there and I go, I'm just blank. I can't think of anything at the moment. So that's my downtime.
Yep.
Other times I'm way alert. I'll wake up alert. Other morning is like a dream time to me. I'm more a night person. I'd like to stay up all night and sleep until lunch. Not till lunchtime. Maybe about 9, 10 o'clock. Not that I sleep, but I like to lay there.
Yeah.
And I've got my eyes shut. And I'm in that time then now and then I reach out and I get a pen and I write something down and I lay there again. And now that I'm a grandma these days, often one of my daughters rings me and says, Mum, can you come over and babysit? And I'm like, oh, this is my time right now. You know, she's ringing me at 9 o'clock in the morning. And I'm
and it's
like,
not that you, yeah, you obviously love to go over and see
adore the
So what I'm picking up here is at the end of the day, just appreciate who you are and what you're trying to achieve in your program, your life, your stories, etc. Isn't trying to tell people how to live their life, but it's saying, take up some responsibility for who you are and make the best life
well,
possible.
Well, if you get a
have
bloody,
your bloody
brilliant,
brilliant life,
if you get you in balance, then you and I, like, as
but
a friend,
then, and as
we
a
have a different connection
yeah.
because you're in balance, I'm in balance, so we're coming from a different discussion all the time. Then if so-and-so and so on, all of a sudden now we're very like-minded. The conversation isn't going about the bullshit.
Yeah.
It's okay, how can we awaken a few more? How can we be better for humankind? How can we, you know, help the planet? How can we be of support? It's a different thing. We're not sitting here whinging. I'm not sitting here saying, oh, my bloody husband did this and you're doing this. It's
and
a different conversation.
Admittedly, I do know every so often when you first walk in and we're about to do a little bit of work, there's a part bit of negativity from my end, but I didn't realise it until, and you never even said anything, as in stop whinging or what,
yeah.
You never said anything.
I'm just going
to
work with you, change the vibration.
Yeah, you never
like,
said anything
at
all. So, but after, you know, just learning stuff about you and whatnot, you don't even need to tell me because I've already realised I don't need it. I don't need it because I've learned.
Well,
it's not,
I mean, you and I have been working together on the, you know, the website and the whole program anyway. So you're great
as a
crash test dummy. No, it'll only take you a couple of months. But the thing is, Nix, is to consume yourself in it. This is like you're going back to school.
Mm-hmm.
You're going back and learning life. Physical life,
but it's like
spiritual
a childlike
life,
side.
Microorganism life, the unseen life. You're learning that. When you get that, what are you going to whinge about? What? What is this? You don't. You just
hang
like,
on a minute.
That's...
It's going to be 5 o'clock soon. I need to start whinging at 5 o'clock because the news is going to be on.
Yeah, that sounds like someone's father.
And not only that, but it's going to make me feel really secure. Because now I know everything that's happening, even though I've walked off and I'm depressed and shattered about what's really happening in the world, I'm still going to watch it because it feeds some type.
And
of
that's
going
to go through and you're going to give momentum to the wars and all that. You're adding all this to
and
it. 69 on
seconds
a greater
is going
to
go off and
all
come back.
Of us, are, you know, there's a whole lot that have got that momentum. So there's a whole lot of same momentum on a global level. It's all the doom and gloom. They've shown, I can't remember what it was, shrimp or something like that. They took some shrimp. And they took them, some sort of shrimp anyway, and they took them out of the salt water and put some into fresh water. These ones went crazy because they're not used to being in fresh water and they blow up. These ones went crazy because they knew. they knew they were connected on a level. They're like, well, something's happening to our friends that are way over there in the other room. They could feel it up. So imagine, and they don't watch the news, they don't get into all the politics and that.
They're shrimps.
Whales. Dolphins can pick up what's happening. Their ocean is their environment. Our world outside of the ocean is our environment. So won't it be wonderful the day when we're all on the same page and we were sitting here and going, whoa, something's happening over in Iraq. So we can pick it up and we can sense it. So we know that there's problems with our fellow cells, our human cells. That's where we're heading for.
And then we can pick it up.
Well, we can pick
cells.
Up that perception. Yeah. But right now, we're only thinking of ourselves. We're not in tune for it. We're not even able to receive that information, I mean.